Jonathan from Rain Brothers here, rainbrothers.com. Today we're going to talk about how to run your plumbing connections to our precast concrete cisterns. On this particular installation, we're putting in three of our 5,500-gallon cisterns, and we're connecting them all together. You can see the 4-inch pipe tying them together at the bottom there. All the tanks are tied together at the bottom so that we only need one pump to draw from all three tanks. If they were tied together at the top, we would need three separate pumps. Once we have the tops on the tanks, we set these aluminum plates on there with some sealant, and then we pull vacuum on the tanks to ensure that they are airtight, which in turn means that they're watertight, they're nice and sealed. We have to plug up all of the 4-inch pipe penetrations as well as the 1¼-inch pump penetration in order to get a vacuum seal on the tank. Once everything is plugged up, we'll put that plate on, pull vacuum, and monitor that vacuum gauge for 5 minutes to ensure that everything is watertight and ready to plumb. So one of the things that we do with our concrete tanks is cast a 1¼-inch brass threaded coupling in the sidewall of the tank. And in that 1¼-inch threaded coupling, we're going to put in this 1¼-inch NPT by 1-inch barb adapter in there. And this is how we connect our water line that will run to the house. So this is an easy way to connect the water line to the tank. Now, the thing to note here is we got this so we can stand in it comfortably, get this fitting in here. But we do always make sure to bed this side of the tank, the pump end of the tank, with stone all the way up to and above the water line. That reduces chance for settling, and if the ground settles over this water line, it can put pressure on that water line, push it down, and create a kink or separate it from this fitting. So we're going to hook up this is 1-inch iron pipe size IPS poly pipe. This is made for underground water lines, not to be confused with 1-inch CTS, which is going to be a little smaller diameter. CTS stands for copper tubing size, and that's going to use a stiffener and a compression fitting, whereas the IPS is going to use these barb fittings with hose clamps to tighten it down. So we always like to use IPS poly pipe. At least rated 160 PSI. Anything less than that is going to be too flimsy, too thin wall, and it's going to kink very easily. 160 PSI or 200 PSI is great for underground water lines. So we're just going to cut this shorter. We're going to use a propane torch to soften the end of the pipe. And then we're going to push the pipe onto this barb adapter. Wiggle it in. We like these long barb fittings. Plenty of barb to grab onto. Grab a 5/16 hex head to tighten these hose clamps. And when we're tightening them, here's a little pro tip. You always want the hex head to face up. This way, if you ever have to dig this up and work on it, you can undo that hose clamp from the top. If you have it facing down here, you're gonna have to dig all this out to get that drill down. Very difficult, so better to have it facing directly on top. Always double clamp. On the inside of the cistern, where we have that 1¼-inch threaded coupling, we install an 1¼-inch by 1-inch reducer bushing. into that coupling, followed by a 1-inch by 10-inch brass nipple, followed by our 1-inch pitless adapter. And this is the fitting that our pump is going to hang from. So we put in our Springer Series traditional cistern pump, and we use that same 1-inch barb by 1-inch male adapter to hang the pump from. What this does is it allows us from outside of the cistern to thread in a 1-inch rod and pull this fitting apart to pull the pump out of the cistern. And then it just slides back in place. You can see it has an O-ring with some sealant, and it will be a watertight fit once it's back seated in place. But this allows for a nice pump connection point inside the tank. Next, we're going to address how we run our power supply to the submersible pump inside the cistern. When we cast these tanks in the riser, we cast a gasket, a 1-inch gasket, in a PVC sleeve that goes through the wall of the riser. Now that 1-inch gasket is perfect for 1-inch PVC conduit that we push through the gasket, and we have that conduit extend just beyond the edge of this tank. That's so that we can put this LB in, and the vertical drop is beyond the edge of the tank. We don't want it to drop into this tank and create a kink point for the wire. So we use this LB as a pull box to pull our cabling. And in this case, we have underground direct bury rated, submersible rated UF, it's called a blue ice cabling. We're gonna run this up through this vertical piece. We're not gluing anything yet. We're just running everything, pulling it through. We're putting plenty of excess cable in the tank so that if this ever settles and it pulls back on it, it just pulls back that excess instead of disconnecting our submersible splice. So we got our LB hooked up. We're just dry fitting it for now, and we're also ensuring that we have plenty of excess underneath this conduit run, because again, even though we're going to bed this with stone and then use dirt about 6 inches above that water line and put this on clean fill dirt, free of debris, free of rocks, there's still a chance for some settling here. We just want to make sure there's plenty of excess here so that if it settles, it just pulls out that excess instead of pulls on the cable itself. So the next thing we're going to do with these tanks is run our drainage pipe through the wall of the concrete cistern. And to do that, on our cisterns, we have three different penetrations. One on either sides, the riser end of the tank, and then a third on the far actual narrow end of the tank towards the top. They're all at the same elevation, so they can you can pick and choose whichever ones you want for your inlets or your overflow. These boots work by they're just a like a fern cove fitting, and what we do is poke a hole in the center of it and pull it out, and then you'll see this cut line right here. That's going to be our guide for cutting that out for the pipe. That will fit 4-inch schedule 40 or 4-inch SDR 35 or thin wall. We always use schedule 40. So we push this pipe through the penetration. We leave enough room for our 90 degree fitting going right here to connect to that drainage. And then we use this pipe clamp around this rubber boot and tighten that with the 5/16 hex head bit. Now on this particular setup, we have three different concrete tanks. The farthest one down the line away from the pump. The pump tank is that first tank over there where the electric is going in. This is the farthest one away from the pump tank. This is going to be where we're putting a drainage. So then we have two tanks that essentially serve as baffles before it gets into the pump tank. That's going to be our cleanest water going into the pump tank. So that's just a quick way to, in addition to pre-filtering the water, to ensure that you have a clean water supply. Thank you so much for watching. Please consider liking, subscribing, and check out the links in our description for more relevant videos on setting up your concrete cistern system.